Cheating at cards is a vast and fascinating subject. With the popularity of hold'em poker taking the Western world by storm, just the mention of the word cheating raises eyebrows. There are many misconceptions with regard to the way cheating takes place at the card table. In many ways, advantage play is far more complicated than you think, and in many ways, far easier than you might be led to believe. Regardless, there are many elements to cheating at hold'em. We are going to start off with a section on marked cards. Here, you will learn about the most popular ways cards can be marked, where the marks are typically located, as well as how to detect them. Next, we will expose the stripper deck and how its odd shape can be used to control any combination of cards at will. We'll then move on to what a legitimate deck looks like as it comes from the factory. Detecting marks is not easy. However, once you know how normal cards are packaged, spotting discrepancies becomes much easier. Peeking is a way of secretly glimpsing the identity of a card or cards. You will learn many different methods and protection tips. We will also touch on the subject of flashing. Like peeking, it's the concept of secretly showing a confederate or partner a card's value. From here, we'll take a look at the false dealing technique known as the second deal. We'll go over the various ways the deal can be executed, as well as practical game applications. Next, we'll talk about the interrelated nature of scams, and we'll delve into the reasons why certain scams are dependent upon one another for success. We will also take a look at check copying, and how easily this scam can steal money from pots, as well as an easy solution for stopping it. Splash moves, or building in, are mainstays of the card hustler. You'll learn what to look for and how to help curb it. Next, we'll take a look at different gambling devices used to cheat games today and in times past. You may find this section incredible. The lengths hustlers will go to invent devices to take your money are fascinating. In our last two sections, we'll concentrate on the proper and optimal way to shuffle, deal, and use the cut card, as well as the safest way to look at your hole cards and why you might be better off using chem or plastic cards in your game. Finally, we'll touch on how and what to do if you suspect or see someone cheating in your game or at a game you play in.